access to clean water is an American issue, and it's a universal issue on this earth, which is why it is, you know, the United Nations Sustainable Development Goal number 6. This is not just a low or middle income country issue. When I was a freshman in college at the University of Arkansas, my department head, he came into our classroom in our freshman engineering class before we had chosen our majors. And I remember he gave a talk about the implications of civil engineering on the society that we live in, and basically posed civil engineering as a really cool way for people who love math and science to serve their community. Being able to thoughtfully influence the built system in which I live, I thought was really important. And for me, water was just such a basic human need, and everyone should have a right to clean water. I am in my fifth year of my PhD in the civil side of the Engineering Systems and the Environment Department here at UVA. We work with ways to treat water in the home right before it's consumed. And this is because in the settings that we work in, if you treat water just at the source, it gives risk for both recontamination during transport and during the storage of that water. And water and sanitation has a huge implication on disease, particularly diarrheal disease, which is a huge cause of death in young children. So I'm working on a new point of use water treatment device, so a new device that you would use in your home to treat the water right before you consume it. It uses something called electrolysis, so when you apply a voltage to metal wires and you put that in water, it releases silver ions. Silver ions, most people don't know this, they are actually a disinfectant. They inhibit cellular respiration in the bacteria in the water, and then they can't breathe, and so they die. I think going into it, I had a pretty firm understanding that there's not universal access to clean water in the world. Like, if you read statistics and you read the paper, like, this is just like people in America. People in rural Alabama, they lack access to clean water because we do not regulate wells there. Ensuring equal and equitable access and providing low-cost ways to clean water allows for improved health outcomes in those communities and just a higher quality of life. Being kind of a global citizen it's been a beautiful experience for me to kind of understand where my place in the world is. We should all use the skills that we have to make sure that we live in an equal and just society.